Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I want to talk about Power BI and how it relates to Microsoft Fabric. So we've been doing a lot of Fabric videos, right? And so we've been hearing a lot from customers, and we hear it in our live streams, we see it in comments. What about Power BI, and where's Power BI going? So I wanted to dispel a couple things, or at least educate you on like where Power BI sits with inside of Microsoft Fabric. So first and foremost, when we thought about Power BI before Microsoft Fabric, it was everything, right? It was the portal, it was gateways, it was capacities, it was workspaces, all of that was Power BI. Well, now that's the platform for which we have many workloads inside of the offering. And so that includes Power BI, it includes warehouses, lakehouses, databases, all of these things, right? And so Power BI is a workload now with inside of Microsoft Fabric. It's still there though, right? And so if you're used to using Power BI, keep doing that. There's nothing wrong with it. You can still do all of the things that you used to be able to do. Nothing's changed on that front. And in fact, there was a recent update as of the recording of this video that I've been waiting for. And this is the new view inside of Microsoft Fabric itself. So enough all this talking, you know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine and take a look. So normally what I would do is go to the URL fabric.microsoft.com, which will redirect you to this app.fabric.microsoft.com. And that takes you into the Fabric portal. If you've been using Fabric for a bit, you'll notice it's a little different. One thing is the persona switcher is gone now. And now it's this idea of a view, and there's only two views. There's the Fabric view, which is what you're seeing here. And this includes just access to all of the items that you would want to do from an all-up Fabric and data analytics perspective. And then we can click and switch to Power BI. And so now I'm just looking at the Power BI view. It's bananas. I will tell you from my personal outlook, I'll always be on the Power BI view. I don't necessarily need to see all of the Fabric things, but if you go to fabric.microsoft.com, it's gonna bring you to this Fabric view by default. So how do we default to the Power BI view as part of this? And so there, I would say, just go to app.powerbi.com. Boom, we're in the Power BI view. That's all I care about. Now, there's a couple other things though, if you are in the Power BI view. If we go to a workspace, and let's just go to AdventureWorks. And if I go to new item, I still have access to all of the Fabric items if Fabric is enabled within my tenant. And so that's okay. I can still do all the Fabric things if I want to. It's all there. One other quick tip for you. So if you're in the Power BI view, everything is where you think it is. There's workspaces right above the workspace you have selected. This threw me off a little bit. This may change in the future. I don't know, but I went and I'm like, wait, where'd my workspaces go? And they're up on top, in case you're wondering where it went. One question we do here is, well, how do I migrate my Power BI content to Microsoft Fabric? And you don't have to. It's already in Fabric, right? So Power BI was the first thing that was there for Fabric. Fabric is an evolution of Power BI itself. So everything you had inside of a workspace still works. If you had a capacity, a Power BI premium capacity, as of the recording of this video, that still works. Note that Power BI premium capacities have been deprecated though. So we're in 2025. You're not able to just directly purchase Power BI premium capacity. You'll have to get a Microsoft Fabric capacity on the Azure side, but all the functionality is still there. It doesn't matter which capacity type you have. With a few minor exceptions, go check out the documentations related to like OneLake or Lakehouse, whatnot. But on the Power BI side, you can do everything. From a project perspective, how do we think about this? If you already had a project that was in flight and you were planning on just Power BI and not Fabric, continue doing that. So I don't necessarily advocate that you just upend a given project that's already in motion to put in the new thing, right? Without really reviewing it, understanding it, and figuring out where it fits. Just because it's new doesn't mean you should use it. So you should evaluate those things based on the business problem that you're trying to achieve. And you may find that Microsoft Fabric offers capabilities that absolutely enhance the capabilities to leverage towards your business problem, right? So that's the whole point of the product offering. You will take advantage of capabilities from Power BI as part of that either way. We still need reports on data. So it's a question of how do I get that data into the user's hands in a meaningful way, quickly and reliably. And so that's what Microsoft Fabric brings to bear, is a lot more capabilities tied into the service to do just that, but you're still probably going to put a Power BI report on top of it, right? So all the cool things with Power BI are still there. And one of the big things for Power BI that came with Microsoft Fabric is this concept of direct lake. And so if we are taking advantage of one lake with inside of Microsoft Fabric, you know, you're using lake houses or warehouses or databases, whatever you're doing, we can leverage direct lake for Power BI on top of that to get massive scale reuse of data and making sure we're taking advantage of just one copy of the data. We've got a whole playlist here on GynaCube talking about direct lake, going through all the things. So definitely go check that out as well. And look, the team isn't forgetting about Power BI either. We're seeing a lot of great updates. We still get monthly updates on Power BI Desktop. We're still getting updates in the service for Power BI. And there was a lot of great recent things that have come out on Power BI, and I'm excited to see what's going to come. We've got the DAX Query View. We've got the new Timdle View inside of Power BI Desktop. We've got Power BI Projects that allow support for source control, things like Git, which is amazing. You don't even have to leverage Git integration in the service. You can just take advantage of that from a Power BI Desktop perspective. We've got the new capability to live edit semantic models that are hosted in the service directly inside of Power BI Desktop now. And don't forget about visual calcs, right? Lots of great things have come. Lots of great things are going to come. So if you love Power BI, just like Patrick and I do, Power BI is still there. If you want to take advantage of the additional capabilities inside of Microsoft Fabric, that's up to you. You don't have to, but Power BI is there and you can just treat it like Power BI. All right. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. I want to hear it. I'm curious, are you just sticking with Power BI? Are you using Microsoft Fabric? Are you giving it a try with the trial to see what it can do? I would love to hear your comments down below and let us know if there's something specific in Power BI you want us to talk about. We're always looking for good ideas. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.